Today we are going to discuss set C++ STL. So this is the part 1 of the video. Later I will upload the part 2 where I will discuss it in detailed manner. So today I will give the brief description of this set. Okay, so first point is set contains non-duplicate elements. What does it mean? So let me explain you that suppose we have 3 elements. Suppose 1 1 3. Okay, if we put it in the set, so this is 1, so if we put it in the set, so first one will be inserted in the set. Suppose this is my set, right? So first one will be inserted into the set, second one will not be inserted because 1 is already present, right? And the third element, that is 3, that will be inserted in the set. So my set will contain 1 and 3. So clearly that set contains non-duplicate elements. That means that every element has a count of 1 in the set. Right. This is a point number 1. So let us now code this thing and let us understand what does it mean. So suppose I have this 1 1 2 2 3, these elements. So if I print the set, we have to print this set in this manner. Okay, then you should see that this thing becomes 1 2 and 3. These 3 elements will come, and the size of the set, let us print that also. So you can see this here. I have run this code and this has become the output, that 1, 2, 3 are the elements of the set, which is that non-repetitive element, and 3 is the size of the set. Okay. So this is the first point, that set contains non-duplicate element. I hope you understood that this thing, right? Second point is you cannot access elements by index. What does it mean? Like in vector or array, you usually access that suppose array of 1 or 2, like this you can access the elements in order of 1 complexity. But in set what happens? That it maintains, actually I will tell in later part 2, that it maintains a balanced binary tree. Okay. And here you have to find the element and modify it or insert a new node, and this way it works, right? So you cannot directly access the element in order of 1 complexity by just giving this index. Like suppose our set is S, and you cannot do this S of 1. You cannot do this. You have to remember that you cannot do this. Fine, let me do this one. So I will show you the code, that how it works, and I will show that it gives a compilation error while we access the set element by index. Now what I will do, I will remove this one. I will just print here. Okay, let me put this and comment out this. Now I will write S of 1 and compile this code. So you can see this error, that no match for operator, like it is not defined in set. So you clearly cannot access these elements like this. Fine. Okay. Now third point, we are coming to the third point. So I hope you understood the second point and first point, right? Now we are coming to the third point, that is find the element of a set using find and count elements using count. So this is a very trivial thing. You can understand that find operator usually find the set. Suppose I have set like 1 1 2 3, okay, if I want to find 2, so it returns find operator. Suppose I am doing s dot find. Find, right? So it will give me a pointer to this 2. Okay. So let me write the code for it. And you can understand that count, what count does, like suppose s dot count of 1. So it will return how many times 1 occurs. And from the first thing you can understand that suppose I have the elements like 1, 1, 2, 3. So you may think that s dot count of 1 is dot count 1 will return 2. But that is not correct. Like when we are inserting them in a set, it will become like 1, 2, 3. So what does s dot count returns? Count of 1 will return 1, not 2, right? 1 will be returned here. And if I put here, suppose we are inserting here 5, so it will return 0 because that element is not present. So what we can conclude that s dot count and this thing count will return either 1 or 0. 1 or 0. It is very trivial thing, you can understand. But hence it contains non-duplicate elements. So it will return like this. Okay. So, I will code this one and let us find that how it works. So, okay. Suppose we are finding 2, then what we will do, we will give it an iterator it is equal to s dot find of 2. And what it will return? It will return the position iterated at the position of 2. Okay. And now what we will do? I simply give an if condition that if it is not equal to s dot end, then I will return that it is found actually. Star it will give me the value 2 is found, and give that else is not found. Okay, now let us run this one. So you can see that 2 is found, is printed. Because what it does actually, let me tell you, that when it I give 2 here, it points to here, and end is the end iterator usually points after the last element of the set, that is after 3 it points. So it is usually as it is not equal to end, so it points here. So this condition executed. Now let me give here 5. So what will it print? That 5 is not found. Actually star it does not gives us the actual number here. Star it will give me this number, that s dot end. Yes, so this is wrong printed, but we can see that not found is printed, right? So let me put like this set, like k and int k equal to 5. This will be more appropriate because as 5 is not in the set, so it cannot print 5 by iterating. this code will be like this. So you can see that 5 is not found is printed. So this works like this. Okay, so let me come at count, that how count works. So I will simply put C here and make it that C is not equal to 0. S, and I will do that S dot count. So what it will do, it will count the number of times K is occurring. Like 5 occurs in no times, that is 0 times. So it will return 0. And if it is 0, then it will print that not found. Else if I put it here, suppose 2. And I have told you that a set does not contain duplicate elements, so it will print 1 only. Return 1 only. So it is not equal to 0, so it will print that 2 is found. So let's run this code quickly. Fine, 2 is found, 5 it should be not found. Okay, now we have understood this found, find and count functions. So let me proceed a bit. Now next thing is that remove element using erase. So how to remove these elements? So simply use this erase operation. Suppose our set contains, set equal to 1, 2, 3. Now suppose I am erasing, I want to erase that element 2. So I will just put this way. Fine. So this will make it erase, and the set will contain 1 and 3. So that is very easy, right? Next is a very important point, that elements are always printed in sorted order when iterated. So I will explain these two points together in a code. So let's come to the code, and okay, I will print this. Okay, so I will do this erase one. I will just print this erase 2, and then I will print the set. So you can see that 2 is not printed now, it is 1 and 3 only. So erase operator, erase the function, removes 2 from the set. You can understand this. Now I am going to show you a very interesting property of a set, that what it will do, that suppose I am giving 3, 5, 1, 9. So you can see that it is unsorted order, not neither increasing nor decreasing, right? Now if I print this, it will give me an interesting result, that you can see it is in sorted order, right? 1, 3, 5, 9. Now it is a very interesting thing that it happens in set only, that when I am inserting in the set in a random order, it actually sorted the array, sorted the element, sort the elements and store it. So it is occurring because of a thing that it maintains a balanced binary tree in its internal structure, in a tree kind of structure. So if you have studied binary search tree, you will understand that when I am going to print the in-order traversal of a binary search tree, in-order of binary search tree, it will give me a sorted sequence. So same thing happens here. You might be thinking that this sort or sort is occurring at order of n times. That is not true. It is actually occurring in order of n log n times. Why it is occurring, like I will discuss in part 2 of this video, where I will explain this in detail, that how this tree kind of structure is implemented in set, and what are the interesting property of set, and how the insert, find, count, this time complexity you know, they have its own complexity, time complexity. So I will discuss them in part 2. So don't forget to watch that video in part 2. And by part 1 and part 2, you will get a good grasp on set STL. Thank you for watching this video and subscribe to my channel to watch more. So this is a detailed video on set. So you watch part 2. Make sure that you watch part 2 also. Thank you.